Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you a technique that will brighten and enhance the eye's irises as well as change their colors. This works especially well for irises that are originally dark. Open a photo of a person you'd like to use. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock.com. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. Let's zoom into one of the eyes. To do this, press Z on your keyboard to open your zoom tool and drag a rectangle over the eye. To reposition it on your screen, hold down the space bar and drag your image. Open your brush tool and make sure the hardness is 0% and the opacity and flow are 100%. We'll adjust the size in a moment. Make sure your foreground and background colors are black and white respectively. If they aren't, press D on your keyboard. Click the quick mask icon so we can brush in quick masks over the irises. To reduce the size of your brush, press the left bracket key. Now, brush across the inside perimeter of the iris and make sure there are no holes in the quick mask. To quickly fill it in, open your paint bucket tool and left click inside the quick mask. Press B to open back up your brush tool and brush over the empty areas. Hold down the space bar to slide the image over and brush over the inside perimeter of this iris. Press G to open your paint bucket tool and left click inside the quick mask. Press B again to open back up your brush tool and brush in the rest. If you need to zoom out a little so you can see both eyes on your screen, press Ctrl or Command and the minus key. Press Q to make the quick masks into selections, and then invert the selections by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selections next to the active layer. Click the new layer icon to make a new layer. Go to the layer mask and hold down Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it next to the empty layer. Click on the empty layer to make it active and change its blend mode to overlay. Make sure white is the foreground color and make the opacity 50%. Increase your brush size by pressing the right bracket key. Now, brush over the bottom half of the iris a few times to brighten it. Then, brush over the screen left iris to brighten it. As I toggle back and forth, you can see that the color is brighter and more vibrant. Click the thumbnail of layer 1 to make it active, and go to Filter, Sharpen, and Unsharp Mask. This will sharpen the details within the iris. I'll choose an amount of 40%, the radius is 10 pixels, and the threshold is 0 levels. Depending on the size, resolution, and characteristics of your photo, experiment with these settings to get just the right amount of sharpness. As I toggle back and forth, you can see the difference. After you apply Unsharp Mask, if you want to make it look less sharp and have less contrast, just reduce its opacity. Next, we'll change the eye color. Make the top layer active and click the adjustment layer icon. Choose Hue Saturation. Go to the layer mask and drag a copy of it on top of the layer mask at the top. If you see this warning to replace it, click Yes. Click the icon next to the layer mask to make the adjustment layer active and drag the hue slider to the right and left to change the eye color. If you want to tone down the color, reduce the saturation. I'll reduce mine to minus 46. To see your entire document, press Ctrl or Command 0. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.